Hall of Famer, Pro Football Hall of Famer, speaking to you now from Lambeau Field and the Green Bay Packer Hall of Fame, one of the finest places in America. Everybody should come here and see this. And with that, I'm going to announce Green Bay's fifth-round draft choice with the 163rd pick in the 2016 NFL Draft. The Green Bay Packers select Trevor Davis, wide receiver, California. Good luck, Trevor.
All right, another target for Aaron Rodgers. How does he fit into the Packers' passing attack?
Sleeper pick, standout performance at the combine really opened everybody's eyes. There you see the numbers at the bottom of the screen. 4.42 40 time. When I watched him throughout the drills, called the ball as naturally as anybody that was there. This is a guy that was a transfer coming in. A lot of talented playmakers on the outside of Cal, so the numbers don't do him justice. When you look at the fact, 12 touchdowns in his career, understands how to put it in the paint. When I watched him at the pro day, ran routes with pretty much precision and polish. The things that I like to see, he was able to exhibit. Ted Thompson has had a lot of success finding receivers in the late stages of the draft. This is someone that they can add to the mix. A lot of teams were able to walk up and press them because they didn't have speed. This is a speed receiver that they can put on the perimeter, and maybe they can discourage teams from walking up and playing press coverage against them and Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah, well, you saw Jordy Nelson's 40 time, which was, I think, what, like a 4.54 something? He wasn't.
It might have been at a comma, but he was a track star coming out.
But he was one of those guys, as we've seen this past year, who could take the top off the defense, and without them, that the Packers offense just really wasn't the same. Certainly Aaron Rodgers missed having him. Is Trevor Davis a guy who could do a little bit of that?
He can give them some wiggle. They have a couple guys that were fast. Jeff Janis, who was a guy that started to make some plays in the playoff game. He has speed and quickness. They need to get faster on the perimeter because they're normal guys, the guys that they normally hang on. Randall Cobb, Devontae Adams, guys on the outside. Those are not speed guys. Ty Montgomery can run a little bit, but they need explosive guys, guys that can create big plays. Their wide receiver core was exposed last year without Jordy Nelson. They need more talented people and more vertical playmakers.
So last year, the Packers, like the Colts, were one of those teams where we just saw a regression. Not a regression. Now, that's probably the wrong word to use. We just saw them not live up to their potential. Do you expect them to revert to the mean this year?
I mean, I think they get back on track. The big thing is we saw that Jordy Nelson is a guy that's very, very valuable to them. They need to get him in the mix. And without him, they lost a wide receiver one. And we didn't know that Jordy Nelson was really a wide receiver one because we always attributed everything to the greatness of Aaron Rodgers. We were fooled. We now know and respect his game a little more than we did before the injury. He returns, should have that offense get back in the mix.
Does it at all change your opinion of Aaron Rodgers, though, seeing some of the struggles last year?
No, it doesn't change my opinion at all. I think all quarterbacks need playmakers, and you took away a big-time playmaker. I think, if anything, I have a greater appreciation for Jordy Nelson and his contributions as a vertical playmaker in that offense. Without him, that offense was very pedestrian, and I now know that Randall Cobb is not a number one receiver. They need Jordy Nelson back to put everybody in the right pecking order in that rotation.